See, friends, there cannot be anything more simpler than this. So, Shakti Raishwari Kachit Sarva Vastu Niyamika Anandamaya Marabhya Gudha Sarveshu Vastushu. So, this is the divine potentiality, power of the Lord, which is Sarva Vastu Niyamika. Now, this Maya, how does it work? It works by controlling everything in a particular disciplined manner. Like the specific gravity of water will remain the same. The metals will have the same kind of properties. The sugar will be sweet. So all these qualities of the objects are maintained and controlled by this divine potentiality. And similarly, the same divine potentiality is also creating the panchakoshas, the five koshas, what we have studied, and then anandamaya marabhya, started from the anandamaya kosha, and then it is as if hidden behind the total world of jiva jagat ishvara. Now this hiding is like what? Get this point, it's a very subtle point. If I say, the ocean is hidden behind the waves, and if I say the water is hidden behind the ocean, and if you can understand this, then you understand this statement, that Paramatma is hidden behind the names and forms, Paramatma is hidden behind the panchakoshas, Paramatma is hidden behind some principle called as God, who is the creator of this world. And these three entities, Jiva, Jagat, Ishvara, they are merely superimposed on this one reality. So till such time we consider ourselves to be panchakoshas, then the world is real and God is real. See, in Tattvamasi Mahavakya, this is the principle wherein we are told, Tvam Padashodhanam, Tat Padashodhanam. Tvam Padashodhanam means purification of your panchakoshas. So you start discarding one by one. Annamaya koshaya cannot be pranamaya, manomaya, vijnanamaya, anandamaya. When panchakoshas are rejected, we have come to a state of absolute immaculate purity called as Parabrahma Paramatma. This is Tvam Padashodhanam. Tat Padashodhanam, what is that God principle? In that God principle, we cannot remove somebody else's clothes. We can remove our clothes. So we can do nothing with the Maya of Ishvara. Then, Daivi Hesha Gudamai Mama Maya Durityaya Mamevaye Prapadyante Maya Metam Tarantite. So we surrender at the divine will and deal with the whole world as a devotee would. So, the Tatpada Shodhanam is living the principle of devotion, and Tvampada Shodhanam is living the principle of Vedanta. When these two things are perfected, like the cathode and the anode, when they come together, a bulb is put, light comes out. That light of understanding is called as God realization. Therefore, here the teacher says, Shakti Aishwari Kachit Sarva Vastu Niyamika Anandamaya Marabhya Gudha Sarveshu Vastushu. So in all the things, the substratum is as if hidden. It is not hidden, as if hidden. Like, is the water hidden behind the waves and ocean? No. But then why do we call ocean and the waves? Because we have got a long tongue. See, we are looking at the Paramatma, but we call it as a Jagat world. We are looking at the Paramatma, we call it as a Jiva. So where is the problem? Problem is in our perception. Meri najar wale apne najar theek kara le. See, What is the difference between the ordinary person and extraordinary person? Ordinary person has to struggle to love somebody. Extraordinary person, he doesn't love somebody as a verb, as an object, but love is natural to him. Like the fragrance is natural to, today they are real. The fragrance is natural to the flowers in the same manner. Love is natural for the wise people because they are no more living at the periphery of their personality, but they have caught the core. And from that standpoint, as a mother looks at her child, the wise man looks at this world. See, a mother does not do love to the child. The mother has love for the child. Next time you see any mother and child, don't look at the child, look at the mother's eyes. See, whatever may be the child, when the mother is looking at the husband and looking at the mother-in-law, that time you look at her eyes. And suddenly the baby comes. See, everything changes. Because in the husband and in the mother-in-law, devils are there. But in my child, so divine. What is that divinity? Child is nothing but the extension of the mother. For the wise man, this world and all the things and beings, they are nothing but the extension of his own being. See? Therefore, friends, unless we go beyond these conditionings, we will be lost only under the disguise of spirituality. Vastu dharma niyam meran shaktya naiva yada tada anyonya dharma sankaryar viplavet jagat kalu. If this divine power, shakti, is not niyam meran, if it is not controlling all the attributes and qualities of the various worldly objects, then this world will be a terrible chaos. See? One day, today, The law of gravity operates 32 feet per second, per second, per second. Any object you drop, you come then, on Monday. On Tuesday, it is 64 bit. You cannot fly any aeroplane. Because every day, the law is different. See, friends, one day the fire is hot. Next day it is cold, water is hot. Arre Ram, kal to thanda tha, aaj aise. See? One day the sugar is sweet and salt is salty. Next day the salt becomes sweet and sugar becomes salty. What a fun it will be. See? You sleep as a doctor, next day you get up as an engineer. Kya ho gaya? Mera screwdriver kaha gaya? Leave the stethoscope and become an engineer. So all the qualities of all the things and beings, they are controlled from within by this divine power. So vastu dharma niyam meran shaktya naiva yada tada anyonya dharma sankaryat. What will happen? There will be admixture of the qualities of the things and beings, and jagat viplavet. There will be a terrible chaos in this world. World is not a chaos, it is a cosmos. Everything is methodically controlled and happening perfectly. See, friends. Therefore, how this Shakti is controlling the world? First, by controlling the things from within. Now, what about the living beings? Chichaya Veshata Shakti. Chetaneva vibhatisa tat shakti upadhi sayogat brahma eva ishvaratam vrajet. See? Chichaya veshataha shakti. See, if you take a bucket of water and in their bucket there is water, and there is a beam of, rather the disk of sun has reflected in that bucket of water. So let us analyze this phenomena. Bucket is seen in the general light of the sun. The water in the bucket is also seen in the general light of the sun. And where the disk of the sun is reflected in the form of a disk of the reflection in the water, from there another beam of light is coming out. So there are two things. In the same manner, this beam of reflected disk will not be on the bucket, will not be on all parts of water, but a particular point. In the same manner, be very attentive, in the inert world, Paramatma reflects as mere existence. The same Paramatma exists as existence plus life in the plant kingdom. The same Paramatma expresses and reflects as the existence, life and knowledge in the animal kingdom. And then we come to the fourth. The same Paramatma expresses as existence, life, knowledge and bliss in the human beings. Now, why there is so much of difference? Is the Paramatma in the inert world inert Paramatma? Is the Paramatma in the plant kingdom is a living Paramatma? Is the Paramatma in the animal kingdom is a knowledgeable Paramatma? And is the Paramatma reflected in the human being is a happy Paramatma? Think, the differences in the expressions are on account of the conditionings and not what is expressing. Like the electrical energy expressing through the bulb as light, through the fan as a movement. So do we mean that there are two different types of electricities? Then why there are differences on account of the conditionings? Exactly the same way. Paramatma, with the conditioning of the total Maya, is called as Ishvara. And the same Paramatma, with the conditioning called as the Panchakoshas, is called as the Jiva. Now, in case of our being, we have seen there is a gross existence called as the gross body. The dynamic existence called as the Pranamaya Kosha, knowledgeable existence called as the Manomaya Kosha, and then the I factor, like you have got a max factor, this is the I factor consciousness, Vijnanamaya Kosha, and Anandamaya is ultimate. So, in the bucket or on the stones, there is no reflection of the sun. It is only in the waters. In the same manner, the Jiva Bhava comes only when, or that place where Paramatma is reflected as a reflection, then Chetanata Iva, then it is imagined that as if it has become enlivened. See, friends, life is nothing but consciousness reflected in the mind as Achidabhasa, thereby there is an illusion as if the life is alive, the person is alive and other person is dead. But in both dead and the live person, Paramatma is equally present. Paramatma never lives. Then what is that which makes a difference between living and a dead person? It is this ability of the instrument called as the body, which is able to express the consciousness as life and which is not able to express consciousness as life. This ability makes the difference. Otherwise, Paramatma is everywhere. See, if we recognize this principle, will we ever bother about life and death? When a bulb becomes fused, is it a loss to the electricity? Is it that in other bulbs there is no light? So when a candle burns, nothing is lost. When a bulb becomes fused, nothing has happened. Because the light is not creation, it is a manifestation. In the same manner, if I die here, nothing will happen to Paramatma or to you all. See, friends, therefore, Chichaya Veshataha, when the consciousness is reflected as the Chidabhasa, then alone the Paramatma is called as Ishvara. And when the same consciousness is reflected in the Vijnanamaya Kosha, the same Paramatma is called as the Jiva. Now take your political example, easier to understand. For becoming a prime minister, you have to be the citizen of the country. See? Now who is the prime minister? Prime minister is the one who is wielding the power of all the votes. When he was not a prime minister, how many votes were at his disposal? Only one. But when he becomes a prime minister, he is now wielding not one, but the total country's votes. And therefore, his signature will have that much value. See, you take other prime minister, like, you know, those who are gone, Devagowda. If he goes and signs somewhere in the United Nations, will it be valid? Because he is no more wielding the totality. In the same manner, the Jiva and the Ishvara. Ishvara is the totality and Jiva is the individuality. But the principle is the same. Principle is not different. We are simultaneously Ishvara and Jiva. When we are under the influence of the Panchakoshas, we are Jiva. When we control the Panchakoshas, then from the same person, out of an ordinary person, a Mahatma is born. Because we are now under the influence of this Prakriti or the Maya, and Mahatmas, they have complete control over the Prakriti, therefore whatever they say, it happens. Therefore, friends, the real spiritual practice is rising above the limitations of these Panchakoshas. It is for this purpose we are studying this. Oh, I thought I had to go and teach my daughter. Save a poor girl. Don't do that. Otherwise, we get lost only in talking about and never come to realize. So, tat chakti upadhi sayogad brahma vrajet ishvaratam. Similarly, this with the koshas, it is the same Brahman is called as the Jiva. Therefore, the teacher says, Koshopadhi vivakshayam yati brahmaiva jivatam. Now, the same Brahman, same reality, when Koshopadhi, now the conditioning is only one vote, so you are a Jiva. The conditioning is all the votes, you are a Prime Minister. Now, see, so what is the difference? Prime Minister is wielding the total power of the nation and the Jiva, he is only suffering the limitations of his individuality. See? Actually, all the voters, they create the Prime Minister. And after having created him, he tortures all the voters. This is how the samsara